Ancient Indian history considers Neem to be of divine origin, and it's imbued with spiritual meaning. This very awareness of the phenomena of what's happening to the neem trees right now is an awakening within us to create our own spiritual air and breathe and live in it. It's like this true condition of progress. So to work together in an act of fortifying the systemic strength of these trees is of great significance to the current atmosphere we find ourselves in today.
So it's kind of intriguing that at this moment in time, when the world is facing all that it's facing and the state that we find ourselves in, that the neem trees are dying.
Here in Auroville, at a sort of educated guess, I would say about 1% of the trees are neem trees. So we've done, Geomatics has done a survey about all sorts of things, and one of the things that they've done is trees. And they've picked up about half of Auroville, and that's about 3,000 trees. So we're looking at maybe potentially 6,000 plus trees of that are affected by this Phomopsis azadirachta, which is a fungus which goes and kills the twigs, which was why you end up seeing the dead leaves on the trees.
You know, the mother called the neem trees spiritual atmosphere. So the fact that the spiritual atmosphere is on the decline is pretty evident, actually. We don't need the trees to whisper that to us. So there's a real feeling and an urge to do something about that, to wake up and to, you know, in one way or the other, help that situation in whatever way we can.
Neem trees lose their leaves every year, and that's a totally normal occurrence. But if they lose their leaves themselves, if they choose to lose their leaves, then the leaves fall off right away. They turn yellow and they fall on the ground. In this particular case, if you look up in the canopy, you'll see dead leaves hanging from dead twigs. And that's how you can really tell that that it's actually being affected and it's not choosing to do that.
A whole bunch of them kind of came up on their own at the beginning. And as we are reforesting, there's less and less in the shaded areas, but we're not yet there. We still have a lot of exposed areas, and that's where the neem is really important. And if they die, we're going to lose all that canopy, and that's going to take us back a few steps, 10 steps back, because then we'll be without shade.
At this particular time, trees are being affected at various different rates, and they're all at different stages of progression with regards to this disease. But pretty much every single neem that I have looked at is affected by this in one way or another.
Also, you know, the neem is like a sacred tree. Every part of the neem is used for all sorts of cures. It's really significant in terms of health care and healing. Physically, in this immediate now, what we are doing is we're going around and inoculating the soil. It's a systemic treatment, so that, you know, it's not just a superficial thing where you kind of maybe try to spray the tree, or it's really getting to the roots of it, which again I find is really significant, because really, if we want to solve something over here, we've got to get to the root of it.
And what happens in these particular cases is that we have a succession of events that occurs in the same way that you get sick, and then if you get sick again whilst you're sick, then you'll be less likely to be able to deal with the second illness. It's the same thing with the trees. But the mix that we're making and the different strains that we're using, what it's doing is it's improving the soil. We don't actually know if this is going to work, but in any case, it will be beneficial for perhaps the neems and all vegetation around.
So if anyone feels inclined to help, the information is in the description below of where and when and how to do this. And we look forward to seeing you. All the help is needed.